In a prism experiment, I1 equal to 60 degrees and I2 equal to 45 degrees and angle of prism A equal to 60 degrees. Then find the angle of deviation. So in this case, what is I1? I1 is called angle of incidence that is equal to 60 degrees. What is I2? I2 is called angle of emergence that is equal to 45 degrees. Then what is the angle of prism? Angle of prism that is equal to 60 degrees. Now we are finding the angle of deviation. What is the D? Angle of deviation. This value we are finding. What is the angle of incidence? For example, if this is one prism, this PQ are the vertices. This is one normal and this is one angle of incidence. This is I1 is the angle of incidence and this is the incident ray and this is the refracted ray. Again here you draw another normal. This is angle of emergence, I2. This is incident ray, this is a refracted ray and this is emergent ray. To PQ plane, if you create one normal, the angle in between normal and the incident ray is called angle of incidence that equals to 60 degrees even. This is the refracted ray. Similarly, the angle in between normal and the refracted ray, this is called angle of refraction. Similarly, another angle of refraction. The angle in between normal and the emergent ray, that is called angle of emergence. Now I am extending incident ray. Similarly, emergent ray. This angle is called angle of deviation. The angle in between incident ray and emergent ray, that angle is called angle of deviation. That we are finding. For that we are having one formula. So this is QPR, this angle is called angle of prism. Generally we are taking equilateral prism in our laboratory. Now, you apply the formula. What is the formula in this case? D equals to I1 plus I2 minus A. This is the formula for deviation, angle of deviation. So what about I1? 60 degrees plus 45 degrees minus 60 degrees. So here we had got 45 degrees, that is the angle of deviation. In this way we are doing problems belongs to prism. Similarly, we are doing another problem belongs to angle of minimum deviation. So, in the angle of deviation condition, refracted ray not parallel to the base, but at the angle of minimum deviation position, angle of incidence and angle of emergence equally comes, and also this refracted ray parallel to the base. In this case, refracted ray not parallel to the base, but at a minimum deviation condition, refracted ray must be parallel to the base, like it comes. Now, we are doing another problem belongs to angle of minimum deviation condition. In a prism experiment, I equal to 60 degrees. Then find the I equal to 45 degrees because this values must be equal to the practical values. Then find the angle of minimum deviation.
angle of minimum deviation. This prism you take equilateral prism, that means A equals to 60 degrees. Now, how we are doing this problem? This is one prism. You take this as a big UR. This is the incident ray and this is the refracted ray and this is the emergent ray and this is the normal and this is another normal. Now this is the incident ray and this is the emergent ray. In this case this is called angle of minimum deviation because this refracted ray is parallel to the base. And this is angle of incidence. And this is angle of emergence. And this is angle of refractions R1 and R2. At the angle of minimum deviation condition, what happens? I1 equals to I2. This refracted ray must be parallel to the base. So, if small d becomes as a capital D, angle of deviation becomes as an angle of minimum deviation, then what happens? I1 equals to I2 happens. Similarly, R1 equals to R2 happens. Now, what is the formula for angle of minimum deviation? We are having one formula. What is the formula for deviation? Angle of deviation. D equals to I1 plus I2 minus A. This is the formula. I have given condition. If small d equals to capital D, I1 becomes to I2, R1 becomes to R2. So I1 and I2 equally becoming. And R1 and R2 becoming equal. And also this refractive ray must be parallel to the base. So these are the conditions. By applying this, we are finding the angle of a minimum deviation. Now apply the conditions. If small d equals to capital D happens, I1 I2 becomes equal. So I1 plus I1 minus A. So D equals to 2I1 minus A. So D equals to, what about I1? 45 degrees. So 2 into 45 degrees minus 60 degrees. So 90 minus 60. So that equals to 30 degrees. This is the angle of minimum deviation. So here what happening? I1 and I2 becomes equal. That we are taking as I. So here I had given I equals to 45 degrees. So this is about angle of minimum deviation.